e to the j theta is the polar form of some complex number, and represented in a complex plane as a vector with magnitude and phase. If theta is variable, then by sweeping theta, the phase angle changes and the vector rotates. If the third axis here represents the phase, then the rotation happens while the vector is moving along the third axis to form that spiral shape. This is the complex exponential function. Usually in electrical engineering, the phase angle is a function of two variables, time and frequency. We can plot the complex exponential with respect to time while the frequency is constant, or we can plot it versus frequency at a single instant of time. The plot versus frequency is called frequency domain representation, while the plot versus time is called the time domain. Frequency and time domains enable us to look at the function from different perspectives. In a time domain, at each frequency, there is a different complex exponential. In a frequency domain, there is a different complex exponential at each instant of time. That's a very interesting phenomenon. A complex exponential in the frequency domain is just a single point in the time domain, and a complex exponential in time domain is just a single point in the frequency domain. If we have a function varying with time like this, then each point in the curve represents a complex exponential in the frequency domain whose magnitude is equal to the value of that point in time domain, and the speed of rotation depends on that instant of time. If we have a function varying with frequency, then at each frequency value, we have a complex exponential in time domain whose magnitude is equal to the frequency domain function at that frequency. The speed of rotation depends on the frequency value. So frequency and time domains are two sides of the same coin. Any time domain signal has its corresponding frequency domain that shows the strength of each frequency contained in a signal. Since each point in a time domain corresponds to a complex exponential in the frequency domain, and any time domain signal is nothing more than an infinite sum of all the points constructing the function, then the frequency domain representation of the signal is the infinite sum of all the complex exponentials corresponding to each point constructing the time domain signal. That's the idea of Fourier transform. Since we sum infinite complex exponentials corresponding to infinite points constructing the continuous signal, the summation becomes integral. Same thing applies to the frequency domain. If we have a frequency domain signal, then its corresponding time domain is the summation of the infinite time domain complex exponentials corresponding to the infinite frequency domain points constructing the signal. This is the inverse Fourier transform. Inverse Fourier transform tells us that any time domain signal can be decomposed into infinite sum of time domain complex exponentials. These two equations are called Fourier transform pair. Knowing the frequency domain, we can get the time domain representation. And knowing the time domain, we can get the corresponding frequency domain.